Now we can jump into science. So I promise I'd tell you how we get fat. So I'm gonna walk you through, step by step, how human beings get fat. Because it's not what you think. It's not how everybody says, you just eat too much, you ate too many calories, you didn't count calories, right? Calories play a role in this because calories do matter. Every macronutrient is made up of calories. So calories do matter, but calories don't tell the whole story. It's the type of calories, right? Because hormones run the show. So let's put this calories in, calories out thing to bed once and for all. And I always say once and for all, but it's not once and for all because I'm still gonna have haters. I probably have people watching the video right now that are like, no, bro, it's just simple energy. If you burn more calories than you eat, then you're gonna get skinny, right? Because they're tests that are done on a freaking Bunsen burner in a sterile environment. There's no hormones, no nothing involved. It doesn't take into account your biology, your anatomy, biochemistry. It takes it into account zero. We're not combustion engines, right? It's ridiculous. Okay, so the steps of fat storage in a nutshell before my head explodes. Okay, so the human brain is incredible, right? So when you see a plate of carbohydrates, like if you walk into the office and like somebody bought you a box of donuts, right? Somebody brings a box of donuts and you look at that box of donuts and you know you're gonna eat it. You know it. You see it, you think about it, you think about eating that, right? So step one, this is you, okay? And you're thinking about eating carbs. Just that thought equals a secretion of insulin. Okay? So you think about eating carbs. You think. And your body secretes insulin. Now what insulin does, insulin is a storage hormone. So it works in multiple ways to create storage. So insulin literally tells your body, hey, we're about to get an influx of glucose. Now remember, glucose equals all carbohydrates. All carbohydrates are processed as glucose in your system. So if I say sugar, if I say glucose, if I say carbohydrates, I'm using them interchangeably, okay? So your body knows we're about to get a serious dump of glucose into our system. That means excess energy, which means we don't have to tap into our body fat. We don't need to use the body fat right now, and if we're not using it, we store it, okay? So insulin literally tells your body to store fat, because it knows energy is coming. So the insulin secreted, it says, go ahead and start storing fat. The next step is you eat the carbs. What happens when you eat the carbs? There is a spike in insulin. More insulin, okay? So you eat the carbs, more insulin spikes, right? Now, these digested carbohydrates, so now there are carbs in the system, okay? So we thought about eating, insulin is secreted, the body sends a signal to store fat, makes you hungry, you eat carbohydrates, you get another dump of insulin. Now, these digested carbohydrates enter your bloodstream. When they enter your bloodstream, you get a spike in blood sugar. Okay, all you diabetics are familiar with this. When you get a spike in blood sugar, there's now free-floating glucose that is flowing throughout your veins, right? There is sugar in your bloodstream. Well, how do we deal with a blood sugar spike? When you have a blood sugar spike, the body, in order to clear that glucose, relies on a storage hormone. Guess which one? Guess what the storage hormone's called? Right? Boom. More insulin. Okay? Insulin. Now, while you're dealing with this surplus of glucose, the body knows, like I said, it doesn't need to touch fat stores. It's never gonna touch your fat stores. It's going to say all the fat that we have, we don't need to burn it. So instead of burning it, let's store it. Let's start storing all the body fat. So now you have a cell, and the cell starts to store body fat. And I'll teach you how fat storage works in a minute. I'm gonna tell you that. This is just the breakdown of how humans get fat, right? So the body starts pushing fat into your fat cells for storage, and this cell gets bigger. And then the cell gets bigger. And then the cell gets bigger. And all of a sudden, you got a little stick man over here who's not a stick man anymore, he's Santa Claus, right? That's why fat looks strange on a body. It's literally a deformity, Like you are maxing out these fat cells. They can grow tremendously to no end. That's also why bodybuilders look ridiculous, because muscle cells are not supposed to be pushed beyond certain limits. So a big, big jack guy looks kind of weird. That's why they need steroids to get there and all that thing, because it's completely unnatural, right? So being fat is unnatural. Being tremendously jacked like The Rock is unnatural. These things are unnatural. We are messing with our biology in really, really serious, really dangerous ways, okay? So this right here is how human beings get fat. Good night, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for attending. This is literally it. This is all you need to know. All you need to know. If you want to be a lean person, this is all you need to know. Now remember, if you are dealing with things like this, if you're dealing with obesity and all these things, then what's happening is your hormones are really, really jacked. So the reason why we need to continue with this, it's not just this, is because we always talk about balancing hormones, because this needs to be corrected. This has been going on for decades and decades and decades. Now remember, most people that come to me are severely, significantly overweight. What did we just talk about? 40% of Americans are obese, 70% are overweight. So people are coming to me already overweight. Now I'm gonna try to do this next part without being too sciencey, and I don't want to, I guess, completely erase this yet, but I want you guys to understand that fatty acids are a form of energy. Fatty acids can flow freely in and out of your fat cells, right? So let's bring back this fat cell, right?
Little cell, okay.
And I wanna make that oval so it doesn't look inappropriate, because I have an adult brain, okay? So fatty acids can flow in and out of the cell, right? They have no problem. It's only when the fatty acid is inside of the cell and it's bound to a molecule called glycerol, right? And you need three fatty acids. That's why it's called a triglyceride. So you get these fatty acids here. These can flow in and out, right? But then you get three of them attached to glycerol. Now you got yourself a triglyceride. This is stored body fat. That's why when people get lipid panels done, I want to know the triglyceride number. Don't give me your total cholesterol. I don't give a shit. I want to know what your triglycerides are, right? So the triglycerides get stored in the fat until the body tells it to release that glycerol and convert it into fatty acids again so it can flow out of the cell for energy, okay? So what happens is the triglyceride is too big, can no longer flow in and out. Now you keep stuffing triglycerides in there, and that fat cell gets bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger, like I just showed you. And insulin is telling the body to do this. Insulin is saying store body fat, store body fat. So the body starts packaging fatty acids with glycerol molecules and creating triglycerides. Now the triglyceride can't flow in and out. Now on top of that, another thing that insulin does is it activates LPL. This is lipoprotein lipase. Lipoprotein lipase, I know, sciencey, sorry. We'll call it LPL. LPL. Lipoprotein lipase, okay? Lipoprotein lipase sits on the membrane of the cell. So let's say this is LPL over here. It's a claw, right? It reaches out into the bloodstream and grabs these free-floating fatty acids. It grabs them and pulls them through. Insulin activates LPL. So insulin tells LPL to grab the fatty acids, pull them in, and fill this thing with triglycerides, right? Triglycerides everywhere. And once they're pushing up against the wall, the cell gets bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. So you have big, giant fatty acid cells, okay? So more insulin equals more LPL equals more fat storage, right? This worked out well. So yeah, so more insulin equals more lipoprotein lipase, grabbing free fatty acids, turning them into triglycerides, more fat storage. Insulin equals fat storage. It is a fat storage hormone. It's a storage hormone, but it is responsible for storing body fat, right? It's insane, okay? So the insulin response you get in order, carbohydrates, huge insulin spike. Protein, very low insulin spike, low to moderate if you're like a bodybuilder or something and you're eating a ton, you're gonna get gluconeogenesis. It's gonna, all right, that's a different story. But protein can have an insulin response, blah, blah, blah. Fat is the lowest insulin response. So that's why this low fat diet has ruined everything. It's literally backwards. It's like the only macronutrient that by itself can't make you fat. And it's the one we said, no, we need the less amount of that, right? So the other thing is, if you want to undo this triglyceride situation, you need a process called lipolysis. Now, lipolysis breaks down fatty acids, it breaks down these triglycerides back into fatty acids and glycerol. Now, this is done by hormones. So we always talk about hormone balance. Always. It's not a matter of calories in, calories out. If you want to break these triglycerides down into fatty acids and glycerol, you need hormones. These hormones include things like glucagon, epinephrine, human growth hormone, right? Your growth hormone is a big deal for that. So you need your hormones to be balanced in order for you to break apart these triglycerides. Now, there are some of you, if you are metabolically broken, this is what they call metabolic syndrome. If you're too far gone, you're too big, and you've been on my protocol and you're not losing weight, your hormones are broken. We need to correct the hormone imbalance or none of this is gonna work. If your leptin, ghrelin, those are screwed, your epinephrine screwed, your glucagon screwed, your growth hormone screwed, all your hormones are screwed, it's not gonna happen. In one of the first ebooks I ever wrote, I had a line that was called, if your hormones are jacked, good luck burning fat. So this is why hormones run the show, okay? Hormones run the show, calories do not. It's the type of calorie that matters. Not the calorie itself, it's the type of calorie. This, everything that you just learned, literally makes you more equipped to give nutrition advice than some doctors. Some doctors, I'm not gonna say all because they're getting much better. The medical community is actually getting better. There is a shift towards functional medicine. Chris Kresser's doing great work, but it's getting better. It is getting better because the economy is collapsing because everyone's sick, so it has to get better, right? All right, I'm gonna take a little break. Right? That's a little bit of science for you.